Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Homi Asuhol, and today we are taking the another topic of the anatomy, that is cutaneous nerves, superficial vein and the lymphatic drainage. So here are some important points to remember about the cutaneous nerves, and that are the cutaneous nerve are the continuation of the spinal nerve and they carry the sympathetic fiber for supplying the sweat glands, arterioles in the dermis and the erector pilorum muscles in relation to the hair follicles. The effects of the sympathetics on the skin are pseudomotor, that is increased sweat secretion, vasomotor, narrow the arteriole of the skin, and a pilomotor, that is the contraction of the erector pilorum muscles to make the hair erect and straight. Superficial veins are seen along with the cutaneous nerves, and these are utilized for giving the intravenous transfusion, cardiac catheterization, and taking the blood sample. Then, more about the cutaneous nerve is the skin of the upper limb is supplied by the 15 sets of the cutaneous nerve. Out of these, only one set is derived from the cervical plexus and the another is derived from the second intercostal nerve. The remaining 13 set derived from the brachial plexus through the musculocutaneous, median, ulnar, axillary and the radial nerve. Then what is the dermatomes? The dermatomes are the area of a skin supplied by the one spinal segment is called as the dermatomes. Remember this term. Then superficial veins. Superficial veins are accompanied by the cutaneous nerves and the superficial lymphatics and not by the arteries. The superficial lymph nodes lie along the vein and deep lymph node along the arteries. So some superficial veins are cephalic vein. It is a preaxial vein of the upper limb and it begins from the lateral end of the dorsal venous arch. The dorsal venous arch lies on the dorsum of a hand. Then the basilic vein. It is the postaxial vein of the upper limb. The median cubital vein. It is the large communicating vein which shunts the blood from the cephalic to the basilic vein. It begins from the cephalic vein 2.5 cm below the bend of the elbow, runs obliquely upward and medially and end into the basilic vein, that is 2.5 cm above the medial epicondyle. It may receive the tributaries from the front of the forearm, that is the median vein of the forearm, and is connected to the deep vein through a perforator vein which pierces the bicipital aponeurosis perforator vein, fix the median cubital vein, and thus it make it ideal for the intravenous injection. So the ideal vein for the intravenous injection is the median cubital vein. This is the MCQ. Then deep vein. It start as a small vena comitance running on each side of a digital vein. These continue proximally as the superficial and a deep palmar arches. Then the clinical anatomy of these veins. The median cubital vein is the vein of a choice for the intravenous injection, for withdrawing the blood from the donor and for a cardiac catheterization, because it is fixed by the perforator and does not slip away during piercing. When cubital vein is absent, median cubital vein is absent, then the basilic vein is preferred over the cephalic vein, because the basilic vein runs along a straight path. And this is the MCQ, that which is the vein of a choice for the intravenous injection. So it is the median cubital vein, and if the medial cubital vein is absent, then the basilic vein is preferred because its path is straight. Then for removal of the priest in a carcinoma, the axillary lymph nodes are also removed, and it sometime become necessary to remove a segment of the axillary vein also. Then the lymph nodes and the lymphatic drainage. The main lymph nodes of upper limb are axillary lymph node. It comprises anterior, posterior, lateral, central and apical group. The other nodes other than the axillary lymph node, there are some nodes that are infraclavicular nodes, deltopectoral node, superficial cuboidal or a supratrochlear node, and the deep lymph node lie along the medial side of the brachial artery, at the bifurcation of the brachial artery, and occasionally along the artery of the forearm. Then the lymphatics, the superficial lymphatics. They are much more numerous and they are collect the lymph from the skin and the subcutaneous tissue. Most of them drain into the axillary node. Then what is the deep lymphatic? They are less numerous and drain the structure lying deep to the deep fascia. Then clinical anatomy of the lymph nodes or the lymphatics. Then the inflammation of a lymph vessel is called as the lymphangitis. Remember that term. Then inflammation of a lymph node is called as the lymphadenitis. Obstruction of the lymph vessel can result in the accumulation of a tissue fluid in an area of a drainage, and this is called as the lymphoedema. So remember these three terms: lymphangitis, lymphadenitis and a lymphoedema. So here we will stop. Here it ends. Thank you so much for watching and listening the video carefully. If you like my work, if you like all the videos, then please do not forget to subscribe the channel. Also hit that bell icon so you will get any further notifications. Also like, comment, share it more and more to your friends. Thank you so much.